does that for? Good luck, is it? You throw it over your shoulder?
I've never done that so far. Never wasted the alcohol. How about we start by saying cheers and shooting this?
Cheers. Don't have it's a shot.
Yeah.
I've never started my day like this, doing Feni shots at 8:30 in the morning. But there's only one guy in Goa that can get you to do that, and that's Shohail.
It's not called alcoholism, it's called being a connoisseur.
Get Creative Goa has been following Shohail for a while. He's got an Instagram page, and the Instagram page is where he kind of puts out all his content about something that he's really passionate about, which is making cocktails.
Yeah.
It's pretty casual, you're in your boxers, and you do the whole, I can't do it, you know.
It's very interesting why I have to bend over. It's because we made a new kitchen.
Yeah.
And my mom wanted the table lower.
Okay.
And I never knew I was going to start shooting that time in our kitchen at home.
Yeah.
And I started shooting, and that was the perfect place where there was no noise. I wanted to shoot on a terrace, but there was a lot of noise. So I found a place, and I happened to be too tall for it. So I was like, time to bend over now.
I hope only figuratively. Okay. So what are we making today?
We're making a Feni cocktail with pineapple, mint, and a bit of lemon juice.
All right, go for it, buddy. I've never made cocktails like this before, so I need to follow everything that he's doing. Okay, what do I do now?
Pour the 30 ml of Feni.
30 ml of... Oh, flipping hell, I already screwed that up, didn't
I? No, you can just pour it this way.
Oh yeah, I can. Never waste good alcohol, right? I think that's the first
thing. I think that half shot already hit you.
30 ml is enough?
Yeah, because... I like this. I like that. He didn't want a shot, but he wants a full peg. So, grab around 10 to 15 of these beads. We'll be putting another 30 after this, but it's easier when there's less alcohol to smash.
And just dunk them in?
Yeah, dunk it in.
Okay, done.
And now Vince, you want to smash?
Oh!
Just muddle it. So muddling, just...
Well, how do you muddle?
Just press and twist. Press and twist.
Okay.
These are life lessons, boys. Press and twist.
Okay then.
This is why I said that this is going to be an 18 plus video.
Smells good.
All right, now comes in to complete your peg since you wanted it. Since even I want it anyway. There you go, this is yours.
Okay.
I use this instead of lemon juice, but I can't source lemons for some reason. And when you use this, you don't need a simple syrup, it's sugar water.
So I'm putting, just dunk it.
Okay, yeah, just dunk it in.
Got it.
Next is the pineapple juice.
Alright.
I think all men learn fast when it comes to drinks.
Ah, yeah. It's an inherent quality that...
It's in our blood. Grab some ice. Just around 4 to 5 chunks of these. Yeah. Close this way. There we go. Slap it. Yeah. And yeah, we're shaking. Let's go back to back.
Back to back.
Now we're gonna pop it. So quickest way to pop it is, you can see this, it's straight here, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Hold your fingers over here.
Yeah.
See, you can see.
Yeah, there you
push
go.
Forward.
Oh, nice and frothy, guys.
Yeah.
Like the waves.
Just put it here.
Okay.
But I'm going beach style.
All right.
And using this. Strain it in.
I'm guessing the rest of the mint is just for garnish.
Yeah, so I kept these sprigs. Just stick this.
Okay.
Catch it here.
Mm-hmm.
And just slap it with the back of your hand. Let's do. Bring out the smells.
That's like a Bruce Lee move, bro.
That's the only thing you can in life.
Okay. And then just put it in.
Awesome.
Cheers.
And there we have it, the unnamed cocktail. Refreshing way to start the day, I would say. 8:30 in the morning. Why not?
It's only 8:30.
Yeah, it's only 8:30 in the morning. It's a pretty refreshing
good habit.
Good habit, start early.
Yeah.
Are we supposed to finish this? Because we're not going to make it to the end of the episode.
The whole group has to have it. This is for everyone now.
What are you going to do now?
I need to chill some more in the water.
Okay, cool.
So Vince, ready for round two?
Absolutely, man. What are we doing in round two?
Well, we're done with Feni.
Okay.
Why not go to my personal favorite?
Okay.
Gin.
Gin.
Yeah, boy.
There's this massive gin revolution happening in Goa, right?
Yeah, it's all over India, actually. So a lot of new brands coming in, and it's actually a really great time to be a gin person.
I get it.
Which is for me, because I remember before the only gins used to get over here were the cheap ones that would eat your liver away.
Yeah.
The ones that we common people couldn't afford.
Absolutely. Okay, so tell me about this one. Does this one have a name at least?
No, none of my cocktails today have a name, damn it.
Okay, so we're making unnamed
we're making unnamed two. Cocktails. I thought of everything but the names, unfortunately.
Oh, man.
That's why if you go on my page, there are so many names that really aren't family friendly.
Okay, so what's this one about?
So this is, again, we're going with gin.
Mm-hmm.
Gin pairs well with cucumber.
Okay.
So we're going with, we're smashing some cucumber in it. A bit of lemon juice.
Got it.
But we're not putting the gin in the shaker because we don't want to beat the gin flavors. So we're going first with the lemon juice.
Okay.
All right. Pour in the lemon juice.
Okay.
Grab one.
One?
Just one.
Okay.
Life rules is always one at a time.
There are some major life lessons happening here today. Major life lessons.
I mean, it's difficult to handle more than one. Cucumber. Cucumber at a time. Okay, that's...
So how many of these are we? Just last time you were very...
Yeah, 15. Like, 15. More than 15.
15 is your favorite number, is it?
Yeah. If you are watching today, play 15 modcore.
15 modcore. 1 and 5.
Let's smash. I already taught you how to smash.
Okay, let's smash.
Vin's coming to me for the smashing lessons.
Oh my god. You can already feel the flavor coming through, like the smell of the...
The cucumber and the mint will blend really well, but not overpower the gin tastes. So that's my plan, not to let the gin flavors die out. Here you go. Ice you.
Does it really matter how much of ice you put in your...
it waters down the drink.
It does, huh?
Yeah. Definitely does. You know the road. Yep. Pretend you're angry and... Surprisingly, my left hand is stronger.
No comments.
I'm a righty.
I'm not taking bait today.
All right. Here you go. That's you. This is me. Trainer. Spring in.
Okay.
Oh. All right.
Oh, so the gin, I like this.
Pouring the gin on top.
Top.
Because gin has very delicate flavors. And you shake it, the flavors get beaten and you don't really get the flavor that well. So usually gin cocktails when I make personally, I prefer if it has to be shaken, I shake it without the gin and then pour the gin on top so the flavors remain. In she goes.
How long did it take you to figure that out? I'm sure you went through a lot of gin.
Yeah. But I realized that when I used to shake it, I should not get that... The nice gin flavor, I might as well have been putting a vodka and ruining it, but yeah. So just top this off with some bitter lemon.
Bitter lemon.
Yeah, so this gets a slight bitter taste. It may not be to everyone's liking, but I personally like it. It adds some character to it.
Got it.
Garnish with a wedge of lime.
It's just for garnish, is it?
So when you give a wedge of lime, it's the choice is up to the person drinking. Whether they want to take it out and squeeze some in.
See? Life lesson number three.
Life lesson
when you
number
get
three.
A slice of lime, you have to decide if you want to squeeze it or not.
Or lick it. Whether you want to squeeze it or lick it. Lessons of life, my children.
Cocktail number two.
Cheers.
Cheers. When I was in school, I used to have something that tasted exactly like this. But there was no gin. But the lemon-lime mix in this is so much like this. So there was this guy that used to make a lemon lemonade opposite at the bus stand in Margao, the old bus stand opposite the police station.
SABINA.
SABINA, is that what it's
yes,
called?
Yes.
I don't know, for some reason it just brings back, takes me back there.
I think we got the name then. So I guess this is called a gin SABINA then, no?
I think that's a damn good name.
Gin SABINA.
This is a gin SABINA. See, we named it.
We named it.
I told you we would get there.
Woo!
We've done two drinks. with alcohol. What are we doing for those that don't want to have alcohol but still want to have fun?
I got something on my mind.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you have a name?
I've not named anything, damn it. We'll name it on the go.
You mean you want to call the drink on the go?
Oh, that's a good name then.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe I guess the next one is called on the go.
Maybe that one's called on the go. See? Get creative, bro.
And we're back
with Vince.
We need the watermelon.
This one?
Yep.
I was having a bit of a snooze back there, man.
I guess this cocktail's got you, eh?
Woo! That was heavy duty stuff.
All right.
What are we doing with this bloody watermelon?
Well, we're hungry, so.
Oh.
Why not go in?
Stab the damn thing.
Yeah.
Why?
Time to go muscle boy.
Okay. Not Woo! Bad.
Should I just dump this whole thing in since we're going? You're making it in bulk.
Okay.
Since you're going to be feeding the full crew, why don't you smash while I just sprinkle some leaves in, eh?
All right.
I taught you already how to work that.
Absolutely.
Let me know when you're done.
Yeah. How do you know when you're done?
It feels good.
Okay, then.
the cocktail. I'm talking about the cocktail. What are you guys thinking of? My God.
Is that muddled enough for you? Oh, okay.
I always like to go in for some seconds. Okay, let's just dump this full thing in.
Okay.
We are putting also some pineapple juice and then we are going to ice this up. So both these bottles are going to be just poured in completely.
Okay.
All right. This is the most I've ever filled my shaker.
All right. It's always the first time.
It's the first time for everything.
Yes, sir. Be careful with plastics on the beach. You don't really want to be leaving these
behind
ever.
If you could carry it when it was heavy, you can carry it when it's light.
So now we what, just pour them in these buckets?
Yep.
Okay.
Half in that, roughly half in this.
You know, these are supposed to be used for making sandcastles, right?
Well, we're on the beach, so it's cool.
Okay, just saying.
We're making sandcastles out of people.
And then what do we do? Just dunk this?
Yeah, dunk this in. Pour it and just spin.
Is there a flamboyant way to do it? Like you just throw it up in the air?
you'll throw half of it out then.
Okay.
So I not put enough pineapple in the start, so just top it off with a little more pineapple.
Okay.
Alright.
Alrighty then.
Ice this up.
Okay.
And that's it.
That's it.
Cheers.
Cheers. Do you need to like give it a shake or something?
You could, if you want to stir everything, but everything should be done good.
Ooh. This is the first time for everything. I've never drunk something out of a sandbox.
Well, we are by the beach, why not?
That's good, man. That is really good. Time for a happy dance. Went pretty well, don't you think?
Yeah, really good, dude.
You had fun?
Oh, a lot of fun.
Me too.
Yeah.
We should do it again sometime.
Definitely. I think we got something in idea.
I think so. By the way, nice shirt.
Hey, thanks, man. You Wait, too.
Yeah. Where did you get it from?
Oh. I got it from Siesta O'Clock.
No shit. Me too.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
God damn.
Good stuff, eh?
Hey, damn good stuff.
Okay, so call me and we'll figure out the next one.
For sure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cheers. Good to see you. That's what happens when you do a alcohol laden chew, don't you?
Oh, that happens.
I think you live that way.
Oh shit.
Yeah,
that's
it. That's